And we said what we wanted was to hear from someone, people who have been healed of cancer, because the doctors are saying this, so we felt that we wanted some people who had experienced healing so that it would help build our faith, because we know healing comes by faith. So we were discussing that last night. So Terry called me aside a few minutes ago at lunch and wanted me to visit with this sister here that has a testimony. So what was your name again, sister?
My name is Ghana. And all I want to say is when Terry was leading the praise and worship towards the ending part, you know, she just stopped and said, God said, send the word, you know. And I just agreed with her at that moment and I said, God did say, if we are not there, we can send the word. And the word can, you know, do mighty things. And as she says that she's not sure whether her mother's got cancer, but I just thought this is a little bit of encouragement to her. So I said, while I was standing there, God has ministered to me. And he says, just, you know, stretch out your hands, you know, towards Terry. And I did exactly that. And I just said, Father, I said, we are sending the word now. I said, you did it for me, you can do it for her. And I said, I'm just trusting you for a miracle right now. Yes. And I stretched forth my hand towards Terry. And the next minute, I felt such an anointing upon me, because normally, you know, when I'm praying for someone, when only that anointing comes, then I know the Lord is doing something. And I can identify this morning and say that God has done something for your wife, because I really felt the anointing. And I'm saying this because I've also... I'm saying this because I've been through an experience. I've also had cancer in my womb, and it started to eat the womb, then it started to eat the intestines. And, you know, the family and my husband couldn't believe that I had cancer. So we went from one doctor and specialist to the other. You know, each doctor and specialist didn't know that we were visiting each other because I couldn't believe I had cancer. So what really happened was, my husband, you know, got very worried and he says, no, we might as well go overseas and, you know, get you cured by some big doctor. So the last professor that we went to was Professor Baskin. He's a Jew. And he said, no, you can go north, south, east and west. He says, there's no cure for this because you lived too long. So when they operated, examined me, my stomach was like 6 months pregnant.
And swollen.
It was swollen. That's the last stages of cancer. And my heels were swollen. And the moment they looked at my tummy and looked at the discharge and looked at my leg, they said, definitely, that's how, you know, they assumed that I had 2 weeks to a month to live. But then at that time, coming out of the Hindu faith, you see, I didn't know the Lord very well. But then I started praying, you know, and asking God, you know, who you were. And then Christ revealed himself to me and said, if you really want to see me, go out and look at the flowers and look at the dog.
Yes.
No man will create things like that, so I am God. Then I trusted in the Lord and I knelt down and I said, God, wherever you are, I said, I'm really trusting you for a miracle because there's nothing in me. I lost the use of my left leg. I lost the use of my left arm. I only could pick up a pencil. Why I say pencil is because a pencil is very light.
Yes.
It used to come up, you know, a foot away from the table and it dropped down because it had no strength in this hand here. And then what really happened, one day I knelt down and I said, God, you know, I said, there's no way out for me. And you have given me such a beautiful home, a big mansion like this, and I'm only a year here. And I've got little children. I said, Lord, if you're going to take me away now, you know, who's going to take care of all this? And I said, Father, this is what I said. I said, Father, I said, I've got no one. I said, you know, when a car is broken down, a mechanic will go and he will buy the part and he will put it into the car and get it going. I said, with me, I've got no mechanic. You are my mechanic. And that's all I said. And the next moment, what happened was, I closed my eyes and I felt a very heavy hand upon my head. It shook me for a couple of seconds. And when it left me, my stomach was flat.
Mm.
My leg, you know, I didn't realize I got up. When I got up with my both legs, you know, putting all my strength together. And I didn't realize my hand was working. And then, just stop there, brother. You want me to continue?
No, go ahead.
Let's finish. And then I couldn't believe what happened to me. Then, you see, I've got a big house and it's got a sunken lounge. It's got 3 stairs going to the dining room. I climbed up 3 stairs and I jumped down because previous to that, I couldn't touch my tummy. I couldn't, you know, I have a bath.
Too sore?
Terribly sore. You know, I cannot express the pains to you because I know what I went through and I just wouldn't like anyone else to go through what I've been through. And therefore, I know what I'm talking with. Somebody say they got cancer. I really feel with them and for them because I know exactly what it is. And then what happened was, you know, I climbed up 6 stairs that's going up to my bedroom and I jumped. There was still no place because previous to that, I couldn't walk fast. I couldn't get into the car. I had to sit into the car and carry my legs and put them in because it was so painful. And I thank, you know, the Lord Jesus for what he has done for me that afternoon. He really came into my life. He touched me, completed his work, you know, the spirit of the moment, like a switch of the light, and he was gone. And therefore, today I could stand up and say, I give him all the praise, glory, and honor, for he is worthy. And to you, Mary, I just want to tell you something, a word of encouragement today. Just trust him and just believe in him, and he will do the work, because I know he's already started to do it.
Amen. So yours happened instantly then? It was an instant
healing. But tell how the pain would try to come back.
Oh, and, okay, you want me to say that?
But before you tell that, babe, you said you were eliminating some pieces of your body that got so bad.
Yes.
Did you say that?
Okay, I'll finish that.
Yeah.
You see, I had no womb at that stage, and my intestines were beginning to eat up. So when I went to this Jew doctor, Dr. Baskin, and I had to take 5 opinions from the doctors that I went previously, because, you know, he had to know why I came here to him. So when he opened this opinions out, the 5 opinions, and before I left home, in my own words, I said, Lord, I don't care what that doctor says, but all I want him to say is, my girl, I don't know why you brought all these things here. There's nothing wrong with you. And look, the doctor could have used these terms, but God gave me exactly what I've asked. So when I got there, the doctor made me sit and he took all the details down about the family, who had cancer, you know, and things like that. I told him, okay, nobody on my dad's side had cancer, but my mom's brother did. He says, I'm not interested in your mom's people, I'm only interested in your dad's people. Just tell me who had cancer. Then I began, you know, to explain to him. Then he said, okay, my girl, he said, let's go into the room now. So he led me into the room and then I had to undress and then he examined me. And then he says, you know, I can't find anything yet. He says, anyway, he says, look, the x-ray is going to cost you 200 rands. He says, could I, you know, do this x-ray on you? I said, okay, doctor, you know, money was immaterial because I need to know now. Because I know in my heart I was healed. But I want to know it, you know, I want to, you know, really, you know, have something to tell others, look here, this is what the doctor said, and there's the x-rays, and I've got to tell healed. Because everyone knew I had cancer. So what happened, he did the x-ray, and he said the exact words that I asked. He said, look here, my girl, you brought all these opinions here, but I just don't understand. There's nothing wrong with you. And he says, you've got your womb back there, and there's not even a pin, you know, spot on it.
Praise the Lord. Yes.
And, you know, and then I said I wanted to tell him because he was a new, you know, he's a Jew, and I wanted to tell him about the Lord.
Yes.
Then I started telling him, you know, I said, you know, Dr. Baskin, I didn't say Dr. Baskin, I said, you know, doctor, I said, you know, I am healed by the Lord Jesus Christ. He said, yeah, we know all that stuff and things like that. And he sent me away. And then he became my very good friend, because each time I went to the to see him for the checkup, because I had to go for it, he said I had to come for the checkup.
What city was he in?
Pardon?
What city was the doctor in?
In Durbin, yeah.
Durbin, okay.
And then, you know, the nurse normally calls the patient in, but he will open the door and say, come here, lady of prayer. Call me and he'll ask me what new happened.
Yes.
You know, he's always wanted to know from me what was happening in my life. And there's many of healings that have come
tell
to my body.
Some of the important ones, about cancer expected. Some
okay,
testimonies
I had,
of people okay. you've seen or prayed for.
Okay, I had piles, right. And when I had my first son, I was very young and I didn't know, you know, how to, you know, go about the labor pains and when to do this and when to do that and what normally happened. I did anything. And then due to that, I had piles. And then I had piles for 7 years. And from, you know, itching piles, it turned into bleeding piles. From bleeding piles, it turned into hanging piles. And then wherever I went, it was very embarrassing. And through that, I never used to go anywhere. I used to sit on one of my buttocks and leave the other one hanging because the pile was there and I couldn't sit properly. And then one day I used this cancer healing. I told the Lord, I said, Lord, you know, you healed me with cancer. And this, everyone's telling me I've got to go and have it out. And I wouldn't want to do that because if God has done something in my life,
that's right.
He's got to be my testimony at all times. And I said, I'm not going to go and have this out. And then I went down very simply where I normally pray. I got a special place in my house where I pray, in the lounge. And I told the Lord, I said, Lord, you healed me from cancer and I believe you can remove this. And it wasn't even too where it fell, it was big as a little orange. You know, I don't know where it fell, but it wasn't there anymore right up to today.
Yeah.
You know, then I had slip disc. I can go on telling you, but I'm beginning to.
Yeah. I thought you said something about you prayed for some other ladies who had cancer. Been healed since that time, and you prayed for others.
Yes, I used to take the factory meeting in, you know, in town, and there was a lady that came up to me. Her brother had tumor, you know, and then we got to preach give testimony, do praise and worship all in 15 minutes. And then, you know, it's an open air thing in the factory because they never gave us no premises. So there was a lady that came up to me and she says, her sister is born with the heart towards the center. And then another lady came up to me, she says, a brother has got a tumor in the head and he's there and went to the hospital for the past 6 months. And they decided to have this op on him now. It's either, you know, he's either going to come out of it or he's going to, you know, either say goodbye. And so what happened, I said, look, I can't do anything for you. I said, but what I can do is stand in the gap with you and commit to the God that's a miracle, you know. And I said, let's pray now. And there was an African lady that came forward. She said her brother-in-law was struck with polio for the past 16 years. And he was at that time about 30-something. And I said, took these three ladies in the front and I said, let's pray. And we prayed a prayer of faith. The next day, the man was going to go for the tumor op. They went, they took him and had him x-rayed again. There was nothing there. I think the following day, they took the lady that had a heart, you know, she was born with a heart slightly in the center. She was having a lot of complications as she was growing. The heart went back to place. And this man that had this polio and was in a wheelchair for the past 30 years, he automatically one day, I think, I'm not sure, somebody nearly fall or somebody ran, you know, or something like that, and he didn't realize he was in the wheelchair. He got up to save the child, and he started walking, and he didn't realize he got up. And I can tell you a lot, but
yeah, we've seen lots of healings, and we just believe the Lord's.
And there's lots of people that I've prayed for over the phone. You know, it's not me, it's just us believing together
trusting
God for a miracle, and God has done it.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Well, now in the